Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at mail stationery. So you may or may not have noticed that when you go to compose a new mail message in Mail, you can choose from a bunch of stationery. The button is right here. It's Stationery Pane. And you have different categories that you can look through. For instance, plain stationery, photos, things like that, sentiments. So you can select one of these and you get this rich text formatted HTML, really, email, and you can change the text in it to anything you want. And oftentimes you can change more than one text field. And it's got a background color and they usually have images. And you can switch easily between these. And in some cases you can even drag a photo to an area to customize the stationery. So you have a lot of different options here and there's a lot of different things that come with mail. Now the one catch is the person on the other end has to have something that can receive and display this complex email. If they're just using a very basic email client or they're viewing it on an online web-based email, they may not be able to see it. Obviously if they're also using Macs and or using iPads and iPhones, it should display perfectly as Apple's designed it for that. But if they're using something else, something older, or something at work, it may not look perfect. Now you can also create your own stationery, but maybe not quite at the level of what you've seen in the examples. So when you're composing a new message, you can go in here and make sure that in Mail, by the way, you have it set to message format rich text or this won't work. Then you can compose a message here and use rich text. Turn on the format bar so you can see things like fonts and colors. And then you can compose your text and create something like this, where I've created some text with some fonts and I've centered it and I've dropped in an image here and I've changed font sizes, things like that. So this might be something I want to reuse over and over again, just filling in some extra text here. So what I can do is say File, Save as Stationery, and then give it a name. Now when I want to create a new message with this, I can compose a new message and then I can click on the Stationery button here, go down to Custom, and I can see I've got Work Party and it fills all that stuff in. Then I can go and customize this particular email right here with some text. And then send it out. Another way you can customize it if you're kind of a designer slash hacker is you can go into your hard drive level, go into Library, Application Support, Apple, Mail, and Stationery, and under there you can find more folders that dig even deeper and you can see all the different pieces of stationery in here and you can go and customize them and you can see it's quite complex with different folders for different languages and different pieces to it. So I'm not really going to go into how to customize this, I'm not going to do it myself, but if you're the type that likes to do that you can start looking into it. Now another thing you can do kind of to hack mail, you may already know this, is you can copy. So I've selected and copied the top banner from my website. Mail really does a good job letting you copy stuff from Safari and then paste it into a mail message and it will take the HTML. So I've copied everything from the top toolbar. I'm going to switch to Mail and you can see I've already pasted in the things in the top toolbar there. So it's kind of a way for me to get some advanced HTML into a message. And once I do this, I could save this, for instance, as stationery, and then I'd always have a way to start off an email with everything here, including all the links in my navbar for MacMost. If you're a web designer, you could design pages in whatever tool you use, simply view them in Safari, copy everything in there, and paste it into Mail as a very easy way to create HTML email and then create stationery from that HTML email. But that's not it where stationery is concerned. If you go to the Mac App Store, you'll find out that a few companies provide additional pieces of mail stationery that you can download as apps. And what the apps actually do is install that inside of Mail. So if you want more stationery and want to spend a little money on it, you can get that. In addition to that, there's also at least one app here that claims to allow you to design mail stationery. It seems to be an HTML editor with lots of features. I haven't tried it myself, but and there may actually be more if you look outside the Mac App Store. So there's a look at the different aspects of mail stationery, how to use it, and how to create your own. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now.
Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.